35 great Indian bastards were sighted there. Thanks to the efforts of Dr. Manakandan and Dr. Rahman of Bombay Natural History Society and the recommendations of its Endangered Species Project, the Forest Department of Government of Andhra Pradesh took the active initiative to establish a bird sanctuary in Rolapalu to protect and conserve the fast dwindling Great Indian Bustard. Aptly, it was named Rolapalu Wildlife Sanctuary as it is nearer to the village of Rolapalu. Spread over an area of 614.19 hectares of dry rolling grasslands located in the Nangamalla and Yerramalla hill ranges of the Eastern Ghats, Rolapalu Wildlife Sanctuary falls under the administrative control of Velagodu Range of Atmakur Wildlife Division of the Forest Department of the Government of Andhra Pradesh. Another 3.13 square kilometers of adjoining compensatory afforestation areas are being added to the sanctuary. Though primarily meant for the protection and conservation of the critically endangered species of the Great Indian Bustard in the Rolapalu Wildlife Sanctuary, we see many more birds. The faunal directory, which indicates that the vertebrates consist of 10 species of mammals, 12 species of reptiles, and 124 species of birds, is an indication of the vast diversity of fauna. The mammals in Rolapalu Sanctuary include black buck, golden jackal, Indian fox, Indian wolf, common mongoose. The reptiles found in the Rolapalu Sanctuary consist of 8 families comprising of 12 species, which include spectacled cobra, common rat snake, vine or green whip snake, common wolf snake, common lizard, common skink, fan-throated lizard, and common monitor lizard. Though the populations of the birds in the Rolapalu Sanctuary are found fluctuating throughout the year due to various migratory factors, different species of birds are sighted in different seasons and in different numbers. The birds sighted here are properly counted and recorded by the staff and protection watchers of the sanctuary. As per the present estimate, a total of 124 species of both grassland and water birds are found existing in this area. Another rare bird which kindles the interest in the minds of ornithologists is Lesser Floridan, which is a seasonal visitor to Rolapalu and an endangered species. The other beautiful birds of the sanctuary are Indian Corsus, Indian Rollar Greater Cowgull, White-breasted Water Hen, Red-wattled Lapwing, and many others. Of all the birds that flock to Rollaparu, the great Indian bustard deserves a special mention. Locally known as Bhattameka Pakshi, owing to its mottled coat of feathers in white, black and brown colors, its scientific name is Ardeotis microcephalus. It occurs in the Indian subcontinent, stretching from the dry Great Indian Thar Desert in the northwest through semi-arid patches of central India and the Deccan Plateau of the peninsular India. Its major range falls in the rain shadow regions of Aravalli and Sahyadri of the Western Ghat mountain ranges. The Great Indian Bustard is a large ground bird with a height of about a meter. It is unmistakable with its black cap contrasting with the pale head and neck. The body is brownish with a black patch spotted in white. The male is deep sandy buff colored and during the breeding season has a black breastband. The crown of the head is black and crested and is puffed up by displaying males. The males have a well-developed gular pouch, which is inflated when calling during display and helps produce the deep resonant calls. In the female, which is smaller than the male, the head and neck are not pure white and the breastband is either rudimentary, broken or absent. The Great Indian Bustard is one of the heaviest flying birds on earth. It is such a majestic bird that Dr. Salim Ali, the great ornithologist, has once suggested its name for the national bird. Once it was so abundant, spreading across 13 states, that it was considered as a game bird and was hunted down mercilessly. A species that once coexisted with humans in the arid and semi-arid grassland regions for centuries is now on the verge of extinction. The population of the Great Indian Bustard has declined enormously in recent times. Their population was estimated to be 1,260 in 1969 and it has fallen to 300 in 2008. Clicking a fall rate of 82% in 47 years. Now the estimate of mature individuals is only about 250. This dwindling trend of the population of the Great Indian Bustard is due to a number of reasons. Hunting down as a game bird, changing land use patterns, degradation and habitat loss, population pressure and industrialization. If the present trend is allowed to continue, the species of the Great Indian Bustards may become extinct within the next one decade or two. Acting on the need to protect the species from becoming totally extinct, in 1994, they were put on the red list of the International Union for Conservation of Nature, IUCN. Unfortunately, by 2011, the population of the Great Indian Bustards dwindled further, warranting they being classified as critically endangered. Sensing the urgency to protect and conserve the GIBs, in 2012, the Government of India have launched a national conservation program to protect the Great Indian Bustard. Included in this program are the Bengal floricon, whose scientific name is Haubaropis bengalensis, and the lesser floricon with the scientific name Cypriotides indicus. The lesser floricon, also known as the lick, is another large bird in the family of bustards and is the only member of genus Cypriotides. This is endemic to the Indian subcontinent. where it is found in tall grasslands. It is best known for its leaping breeding displays made by the males during the monsoon season. The lesser florican is a slender bird with longish bill and legs. Male has stipulated head plumes, black head, neck and underparts. It has a white collar across upper mantle with white wing covers. Female and immature birds are sandy or cinnamon buff in color. They croak just like frogs during display and when flushed, short whistles. This species of the lesser florican qualifies as endangered because it is very small and very rapidly declining population. Its decline warrants its urgent attention, immediate protection and conservation. The sightings of the lesser floricans are keenly observed and scrupulously recorded by the protection and watchers of the Rolabaram Wildlife Sanctuary. This sanctuary also harbors the largest known wetland population of harriers. Most common is the Mutagus, the scientific name being Circus macrolurus, and the pied harrier with its scientific name Circus melanoleucos. About 1,000 harriers are present during winter in the Rolabaram Wildlife Sanctuary and are seen mainly in the evening when they come to roost in the grasslands. Though the present conditions are significantly in real need to help to maintain and sustain the Rolabaram Wildlife Sanctuary. At present, the area of the sanctuary is very small.